I need to find out more information. On that particular day, the 15th day of January, 1974, can you tell me where you went to kill Mr. Joseph Otero?
I think it's 1834. Edgemore.
All right. Can you tell me approximately what time of day you went there?
Somewhere between 7 and 7:30.
This particular location, did you know these people?
No, that's... No, that was part of my, I guess my, what you call fantasy. These people were selected.
All right, so you...
Okay.
You were engaged in some kind of fantasy during this period of time?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, when you use the term fantasy, is this something you were doing for your personal pleasure?
Sexual fantasy, sir.
I see. So you went to this residence, and what occurred then?
Well, I had did some thinking on what I was going to do to either Mrs. Otero or Josephine, and basically broke into the house, or didn't break into the house, but when they came out of the house, I came in and confronted the family, and then we went from there.
All right. Had you planned this beforehand?
To some degree, yes. After I got in the house, I lost control of it, but it was, you know, in the back of my mind, I had some ideas what I was going to do, I basically panicked that first day, so.
Beforehand, did you know who was there in the house?
I thought Mrs. Otero and the two kids, the two younger kids were in the house. I didn't realize Mr. Otero was going to be there.
All right. How did you get into the house, Mr. Reagan?
I came through the back door, cut the phone lines, waited at the back door, had reservations about even going or just walking away, but pretty soon the door opened and I was in.
All right. So the door opened. Was it open for you or did somebody?
I think one of the kids, I think the junior... Or not junior, yes, the younger, Joseph, opened the door. He probably let the dog out because the dog was in the house at that time.
All right, when you went into the house, what happened then?
Well, I confronted the family, pulled a pistol, confronted Mr. Otero, and asked him to, you know, that I was there to, basically, I was wanted to get the car. I was hungry, food I was wanted, and asked him to lie down in the living room. And at that time, I realized that wouldn't be a really good idea. So I finally, the dog was a real problem, so I asked Mr. Otero if he could get the dog out. So he had one of the kids put it out. And then I took him back to the bedroom.
You took who back to the bedroom?
The family, the bedroom, the four members.
All right, what happened then?
At that time, I tied him up.
While still holding him at gunpoint?
Well, in between tying and yes. Yeah.
All right. After you tied them up, what occurred?
Well, they started complaining about being tied up, and I re-loosened the bonds a couple of times. Tried to make Mr. Otero as comfortable as I could. Apparently had a cracked rib from a car accident, so I had him put a pillow down for his head. Had he put a, I think he's a Parker or a coat underneath him. They talked to me about, giving the car and whatever money. I guess they didn't have very much money. And there I realized that, I was already, I didn't have a mask on or anything. They already could ID me and made a decision to go ahead and cut him down, I guess, or strangle him.
All right. What did you do to Joseph Otero? Senior.
Joseph Otero?
Yeah, okay. Joseph Otero Sr., Mr. Otero, the father.
I put a plastic bag over his head and then some cords and then tightened it.
And this was in the bedroom?
Yes, sir.
Did he, in fact, suffocate and die as a result of this?
Not right away. No, sir, he didn't.
What happened?
Well, after that, I did Mrs. Otero. I had never strangled anyone before, so I really didn't know how much pressure you had to put on a person or how long it would take. But
Was she also tied up there in the bedroom?
Yes, uh-huh. Yeah, both her hands and their feet were tied up. She was on the bed.
Where were the children?
Josephine was on the bed, and Junior was on the floor at this time.
So we're talking, first of all, about Joseph Otero. So you'd put the bag over his head and tied it,
mm-hmm.
and he did not die right away. Can you tell me what happened in regards to Joseph Otero?
He moved over real quick-like, and I think tore a hole in the bag, and I could tell that he was having some problems there. But at that time, the whole family just went, they went panicked on me, so I worked pretty quick.
You worked pretty quick.
Well,
what
I mean, I strangled Mrs. Otero, and she went out, or passed out. I thought she was dead. She passed out. Then I strangled Josephine. She passed out, or I thought she was dead. And then I went over and put a bag on Junior's head, and then if I remember right, Mrs. Otero came back. She came back and.
Sir, let me ask you about Joseph Otero Senior. You indicated he had torn a hole in the bag.
Mm-hmm.
And what did you do with him then?
I put another bag over it, or either that or a. I recollect. I think I put a either a cloth or a T-shirt or something over it, over his head, and then a bag, another bag, and then tied it down.
Did he subsequently die?
Well, yes. I mean, I didn't just stay there and watch him. Then I was moving around the room. But
all right. So you indicated you strangled Mrs. Otero after you had done this. Is that correct?
No, I went back and strangled her again. That finally killed her at that time.
So this is in regards to count two. You had, first of all, put the bag over Joseph Otero's head,
mm-hmm.
and he tore a hole in the bag.
Mm-hmm.
Then you went ahead. Did you strangle Mrs. Otero then,
okay.
or did you go
first
back?
First of all, Mr. Otero was strangled, or a bag put over his head and strangled. Then I thought he was going down, and I went over and strangled Mrs. Otero, and I thought she was down. Then I strangled Josephine while she was down, and then I went over to Junior and put the bag on his head. After that, Mrs. Otero woke back up, and she was pretty upset at what's going on. So I came back and at that point in time strangled her for a death strangle at that time.
With your hands or what?
No, with a cord, with a rope. And then I think at that point in time, I redid Mr. Otero, put the bag over his head, went over and then took Junior. Before that, she asked me to save her son. So I actually had taken the bag off, and then I was really upset at that point in time. So basically, when Mr. Otero was down, Mrs. Otero was down, I went ahead and took Junior. I put another bag over his head and took him to the other bedroom at that time.
What did you do then?
Put a bag over his head. I put a cloth over his head,
T-shirt,
and a bag so he couldn't tear a hole in it. And he died from that. And then when I went back, Josephine had woke back up.
What did you do then?
And I took her to the basement and eventually hung her.
All right, you hung her in the basement?
Yes, sir.
All right, did you do anything else at that time?
Yes, I had some sexual fantasies. But that was after she was hung.
All right. What did you do then?
Went through the house, kind of cleaned it up. It's called the right-hand rule. You go from room to room, picked everything up. I think I took Mr. Otero's watch. I guess I took a radio. I'd forgot about that, but apparently I took a radio.
Why did you take these things?
I don't know. I have no idea. Just...
What happened then?
I got the keys to the car. In fact, I had the keys, I think, earlier before that because I wanted to make sure I had a way of getting out of the house and clean the house up a little bit, make sure everything's packed up and left through the front door. And went over to their car and then drove over to Dylan's and left the car there. Then eventually walked back to my car.
All right.